There we are. Is that better? Ah, yes. Now I'm good. I think I'm good. Hello. Yes. I had the mute on my camera. Clever of me. Okay. So that's that. Now what's going on here? Have I got... Oh, good. Just checking my... Click on that. I get my chat. Right, that's that done. Good, 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 and good. Okay. I think this is just a normal part of starting a stream, is that you can't, nothing, it just doesn't bang happen. You have to set yourself up. So I am, well, I painted this a few days ago, and today I'm going to paint another one, not exactly that, but a different kind of dog, which is up here, Dingo, into this abstract background that I've already painted. But I've got a choice of this abstract background or this abstract background. These are boards, and I like these boards. And I'm not sure which one to do. Mind you, I've got all the paint out for this one. So I could go with that one there, couldn't I? You know, I was really happy with the way that turned out. There's nothing on the back of that one, it's just blue. So that one's done, and I'm happy with that. So I can put that behind there, or maybe I should pin it up somewhere. Actually, let me just put that down. Let me just move a few things around a bit. As you can see, I'm super duper organised, which is nothing unusual for me. Look at that. I need another clip, don't I? Grab this one over here. So I've been really enjoying doing these abstracts. Well, I do know why. It's just, you don't have to think. So what I've been doing is just picking a couple of colours, black and white, and a couple of brushes, and maybe a Posca pen, which does these little marks down here, and just sort of throwing it on in layers to make these abstracts, and that's been real fun. And the other thing I do is just chuck leftover paint on as well. And just chuck it on, so I've got something on the background. And then, so that's the abstract component of it. And then I decide, if I like them, I'll emerge something into it, an animal. I'm going to do an animal today. I'm going to do that dingo. Or I could do, you know, I could do anything really, person or something. But it's just a bit of fun. So which one should I do? So whichever side I choose to paint on, the other side's just going to be the back of the painting, and then I'll pop it on my these are products that are going to go on my blue thumb. So I don't know. Anyway, so I'm just thinking a more colourful dingo, which will go with that one really, I guess. Or a more kind of native-y looking one. We could go with that. But then that makes a nice back of the painting too. But it would make a good dingo, I reckon, because it's kind of got that Australian feel to it. All right, maybe I'll do that one. Pretty limited palette on there. So my next thing is, which way do I make it go, you know? That way, I've got nose down here, face, body, which means that'll be across the top. Or do I want that across the top, which is kind of nice. Face, nice, and pretty boring up there. That across the top. I actually quite like, that could be quite nice down the side as well. With that across the top and dingo all in here. Maybe that way. It's either that way or that way. Ears about here. Nose about here. And that way. Okay, that way. That way. The decisions we have to make that way or that way. Actually, if I look at it on the screen, I get another perspective. I think I'm going to go that way. It's got this sort of feeling of it that way. Okay. So that. Now this can be mixed media, so I'm not particularly, I don't have to start with paint, so I'm going to plot it out. So I can use, I've got some, this is soft pastel, so I can plot it out. So I'm thinking, I'm going to have a nose about here. Well, the bottom can come up here, about halfway. So we've got bottom. We've got ear and ear. Ear. Little gap between the ear. Here. So, no, this is got to be more, it's in the middle here. Now the beautiful thing about these soft pastels is I can take a little sponge and wipe out my mistakes quite easily. So I've got this front ear in the beginning here, so I'll put that one there. Just get that one here. There's the back. Front ear there. Put a head. Nose down here. So the thing with working into this background, eye's going to be about here, isn't it? Is you do get a lot of confusing and conflicting things happening with all this stuff that's already on the book, on the painting. So it really can throw your eye. But we'll get there. We will get there. I'm going back down that way more, which means I'll keep that nice area there. Yeah. A fairly big ear, I reckon. There. There. Ear here, so. Yeah, okay. Going to be interesting. I think I've thrown that a bit further, too far back this way, so it's got to, this side's got to be here. Move the side forward this way. I can use some, oh, what's this? Graphite. I'm going to use a bit of that. Why not? It is mixed media. Nose is down here. Nose is actually down here. Graphite. It's interesting stuff. Graphite's a bit more permanent than the soft pastel. That's really. I'm just getting. I'm going to keep this kind of abstracty feel with the. I think that eye's a bit high. So I'm going to put the eye in actually. I'm going to get some black on my palette. So I'm going to use carbon black. I do have a limited palette here, which is carbon black, vermilion, which is that redy orangey colour, and light red ochre, which is quite an interesting colour. I'm also using this weird mix of Australian yellow green that I made myself. Oh, here it is. Really interesting colour, this one. I'll show you there. That mixed with black gives me this, and white gives me that interesting colour there. And, get off there. Right. Now, where's. Oh, I want a little brush. Now, if I just put this, just draw this in with a bit of paint. Now, draw these main bits in just so I can see it really. That's why I'm doing it. I can't see what I'm doing. So we've got this bit of ear up here. This bit of nose, I think I've made too long, so I'm going to put that there. A bit of nose, a bit of mouth. Yeah, like that. And just sort of see it where it's going to be so I can figure out what I need to do, because I don't want to lose too much of this abstract background. That's the thing. That is the thing. So I'm working with the colours I've got on there. So I'll put some of that weird green colour I made out. I actually don't want to introduce any more colours. I've got white, black, that green. And red, and actually I did also premix a grey. Hey, how are you feeling? How are you? Here's a grey. How are you going? It's pretty cold today, isn't it? Again, very cold. It's just, I'm rugged up. So I'm making a kind of yellowy, grey, blacky colour here. I did have a bit of yellow ochre on there too, so I'm drawing still. I'm at a drawing stage. Is that too high? I've got to check myself. Not great. Oh, kicked in, has it? It's what are your symptoms like? Have you got a cough? Headache, I think sore throat is one of the symptoms apparently. Patrice had it, my daughter. She had the COVID and she wasn't sick for too long, but yeah, you get a bit of a sore throat apparently. All of them, yeah. You gotta rest up. Gotta rest up now. Don't you? What is it? Oh, it's sucky. It sucks. It sucks. One ear there and one ear there. Okay, so now I'm thinking. Oh, I'll put my colours out now. I'll enjoy a rest. Not that you can enjoy anything when you're not feeling too good. Hot cups of tea. Actually, whenever I'm sick, I like to continuously drink. In fact, I do it anyway. Warm, hot tea, herbal tea or something like that. Because apparently any bugs in your throat don't like hot drinks continuously going down there, so it kind of kills them as it goes. I'll take some of this vermilion orange. I'm gonna get this bit. We've got a bit down here. Bit down there. I'm gonna take some of that green and grey. It's interesting using this limited palette, that's for sure. Oh, that's a nice colour. I get these beautiful khaki kind of greens in here, which I do quite like. My emerging dog. Emerging dingo. Okay, so we've got inside of the ear. Just tweak the shape of that ear as I go. If I move across to the other ear, this one. So there. Ooh, cheeky. Right, might create. Oh no, not drips, but I want to actually wipe that bit while it's wet still, and I can just rework that shape because I don't want to lose that bit of background, I reckon. So I think I need to shape the back of that head there. With what colour though? I might use that orange with a bit of white actually. I might use the, what was that other colour? The red, light red ochre with a little bit of white in it. Now where's my white? What do I do with my white now? No, not that white. Oh, here it is. Okay. To get this. A lot of thinking. This is a thinking project. Actually, I need a bit of ochre on there. Oh, I'll put a bit of green in it. That green. Yeah, that, because that green's got a lot of yellow. I get a beautiful colour with that. So I can draw this line. Line of the back of the head. I could get the tip of the ear probably. I could also get this back of that ear there. I think could be a good one to get. And while I'm here, I'll just get that bit of the head. And is my eye in the right place if that head is there? And I think I need to move it. I need to move it. Yeah, a little bit across. That's all right though. I don't mind moving things. It's gonna be more here actually. I think let's go that way. Move my eye to there. I think. I'm going to put some yellow ochre on to help with that. No, not yellow ochre. It's raw sienna. It's a very similar colour to... Yes, I definitely want to go to the Archibald exhibition. That's open till October, so it's quite a long exhibition. Are you going to go? I think it will be really interesting, actually. So I do want to go. Just put that there. It's a bit wet for a minute. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Maybe I've made that ear too big. No, it's okay. Might have made it a bit too long. Yes. Fabulous. I think. Need some grey. Grey. Very weird little palette, this one I've got here. It's really... strange kind of palette, and I'll put a bit of that in there, and I will actually just chisel out this nose area there. I'm gonna have to tweak that drawing stage. Made a few blunders in my drawing, but it doesn't matter. I never worry too much, because while the paint's wet you can move it around and you can always make corrections. So I need to lower that pulse thing. Yes. Okay. Yeah, you'll go. Yeah. So I'm glad it's on for such a long time. That's a really good thing. It looks good. Yeah, it does, doesn't it? Okay. Let's just... Ooh, I think I've... might have gone a bit full on with that green, but let me just see what happens with it. Back here. Right. Okay. Take some of this. We've got to keep standing back for this one. This is quite... I'm going to kind of keep some of these little interesting circles here. That's interesting. A bit of black in with my brown. Now he's emerging. Yeah, touring show I actually think it's from a few years, like not just 1 year. It goes back, I think. Yeah, so So it's got, because that Del Catherine Barton one, I think that's in it. That was from years ago. Oh, now we're cooking. So I'm going to have to, what am I going to do down here? I'm going to actually, see these circles down here? I'm going to add some in the background, behind the mouth and the animal actually. See if I can work that out like that. Oops. Okay. I just want to change the angle of that mouth. Where's my grey? So the angle of the mouth, it can go up a bit more like that. And down here, there's my white. Do, do, do. Now, and that means that's going to come down. I need a nice grey for that mouth. So I'll bring that mouth down there like that. To go over there like that. See if that works. Let's wipe that bit. And oh, there's the white. Straight out of my pot. Just to get the bottom of that mouth there. I need to do the minimum, you see. Drag some of that up there like that. Now I'll just I feel like I want to add some blue onto my palette, but I also don't want to change my palette because I like the palette. So I'm gonna have to, I think I'm just gonna have to mix the yellow in with the black to get more of a green than a blue. See if I can get away with that. I don't want to though. Get rid of that. Put that bit of black in there. And he's kind of grinning a bit. That's okay. I'm going to use my wet brush just to take away, because I don't think I need that there, so I'm going to take it away while it's wet. Taking away is also a form of drawing, so I can do that if I've got the right stuff underneath. Okay. Now if I did add blue into my palette, no I can't. I'm not going to add blue into my palette. I'm going to stick with this grey. Okay, so I'm just going to tweak this nose a bit first. Maybe I'll put a few of those dots there. And say the top of that nose there with a bit of that white. And the top of the nose here too. Give it a bit of shape. Okay, right. Just want to get this eye to stand out a bit more before I continue, because the eyes are really kind of important. I've got this shallow ochre. I've also got this nice light red ochre. Maybe I can use a bit of that mixed with yellow ochre to get a variation on my brown for that eye, just to see if I can make that stand out a bit more. Take the black. I really want to do the minimum so that I keep that nice spontaneity. I see some problems. Okay. Going to the greys. Make this eye sort of stand out a bit more. Keep my marks really just loose. There's something happening in there and there. Is that eye big enough? I wonder if I should make it bigger. Well, that Del Catherine Barton one did. And I'll protect on the protect on the cultural objects of that's interesting. It'd be really, really good. Really, really good to see that. Look, you know, the paintings are so different in real life. Cause size for a start, the impact of size, it's huge. Big paintings look really different in real life, don't they, than small paintings. I'm glad it's on for a long time, because that will be really good. More white. I'll put a little bit of light there. And a little bit of light under here. And actually, I'm going to have to get that grey. Just cut into the nose a bit there. So, I wonder if I should chisel out some of that background there. What next is the question. So we'll go and get that bit of neck. And I'll have to do something about that. So I might get that greeny grey. Again, a bit of black in there, a bit of that green, and lots of white. Try this, we'll drag this colour. So that colour's gonna be help. But I really like that. Okay. So I can do some reverse painting again. need some tea. More tea. I shall make myself some tea. Let's take that on there. This kind of reverse drawing, pushing it around while it's wet with my brush, just letting it get a bit transparent so you can sort of see what's underneath, but it helps with the form, create this form of the dingo as it emerges out of that background. The emerging dingo. Need a bit of tone in that ear. Do this ear here. Okay, that one. That's interesting. Stop happening there. Go that way. Right, what next? What next? A bit of grey. More grey. Oh, I don't like grey. So, I love these Posca pens too. Where is that Posca? Oh, these Posca pens, which are acrylic paint pens. Yeah, you can get some interesting sort of things happening with them as well. So, they actually are acrylic paint, so you can draw in there with them, do some line work. I kind of really like some of the things that happen with them. It's a different kind of effect, really. Probably better if you use them going like downwards, So, okay, I'm going to make the eye a little bit bigger. I do want it to stand out, even if it's not actually bigger in real life. I'll make it bigger than it needs to be, because then I get to see it more bigger. Yeah, a bit bigger like that, probably better. Yes, bigger. As I said before, I really like making, you know, mistakes and or correcting things like that, because it just adds to the interest of what's going on. I'm never too worried about changing things. It's a bigger eye. Now I can see it. Yes, I can see it. And we'll go. Too big now. It's alright, I can easily fix that by just putting this bit in there. Taking that, going a bit across there. Big guy now. Slightly make it smaller by just getting dark in there. And just get that other eye on that side. Right. Now, how's that looking? Okay. Back to the white. I'm going to get a kind of scrapey brush. Scrapey brush. And I am going to drag some of this down into here. And through the middle there. And maybe even a little bit there. That's interesting. So now I'm wondering how much do I want to sort of do an edge or fill him in or what, you know? So if I mix, I can kind of draw into this with my paintbrush. Give it some form. You know, that might just be all I need to do. Scribble into that a bit, which I don't mind. I don't kind of mind that. Using a bit of a dry brush. Like that. I want to sort of section his body out a bit here, because this is body here, this is background. So his body's sort of here, and that could be light. I could get, light grey in there. Right. Lots of white, and a little bit of grey. A little bit of grey, maybe a little bit of that green, a little bit more of that green, because it seems to be set back. Maybe a bit of yellow in there. Let's get a colour that's going to work. Try this. Try it. Does that look like body? Is the question. I work quickly and I change my mind, I can take it out and see. So I will work quickly. Do I take all these dots out from the bottom here? Most of them anyway. Yeah, probably should. Which means that goes on there. And grey. So So I might want to make this background behind here kind of stand out a bit more. So I will get some of that browny red there, and I mix that up. My red, light red ochre, and probably a tiny bit of black in there. Any white? Yeah, white. Oh, that might be that more light red ochre. A little bit of white. Yeah, that's good. Alright, so I'm going to just cut in between to make the background stand out between his mouth and the background. So that's all I need to do. Do the minimum. Very important. Okay, well that kind of works. Now what? Grey. That's why I'm looking in his ear now. So can get some bit of form here. Does the other ear need a little bit more form in there? And some dark. I need more dark in that ear. So I can a little bit of form in here. Some of that green in there. Bit of mixing going on. It's all acrylic paint, so do I keep the circles in his body? Is the question. I kind of like them. Yeah, I do. I need to make this ear stand out a bit more or something somehow there. So maybe I'll use that Posca pen again. And that bit there. So time 1:12. So okay. I have no idea what time I started. I'm going to top up my tea. And I do need to soften those Poscopin lines. Wonder if I should put some more sort of, okay, well that, all right, I'm gonna take that gray from the inside of the ear. With a bit of green in it, actually. I like that green and grey. This one. And just... soften that, but I also need to soften that line there. This one. Just tweak the shape of that. Tweak the shape of the top of it as well. Yes, and this one. Blur that edge there. You know what I have got? Now, where did I put it? It's this sponge thing. What did I do? Oh. Can never find anything when you want it. No, I don't know what I've done with it now. I had a round sponge, so I can make these round marks here. I'd love to press some round things on there like that. I don't think I can find it when I need it. What else have I got that I can make some marks with? Oh, so a little bit of sponge here. I'm going to cut it into a round circle. I'm just going to cut it into a shape, kind of a round shape with scissors. It's not perfectly round. It's kind of a rounder shape. And I'm going to. Well, I don't know, I need more paint than that. Try this. Not as good as my other one. It's a bit. No, I don't know if I like that. I don't think I like it very much. What else can I do? Mix up a grey. Come down here a bit. Following some of the lines. Go up here a bit. Some of these colours. take that black down there. It's kind of in a ear thing. What's going on? I don't mind it. I could fill out some of those spots. With orange or the light red ochre? I might try the orange actually. I shall put it in this clean palette. Add a little bit of just straight orange to it. So if I kind of go. Oh. And then the brown maybe. I like that one. Just put one there. Maybe one there. Maybe one kind of here. Ooh, I wonder now if I should add some more of those lines into the background across. I could with this Posca pen. Let's try it. Kind of makes him stand out a bit more. But I don't want to overdo it too much. What about down lower or down below that black mark? What else? What else? I mean, I could work on his nose a bit more. I think I've got to sit on this. I might put a few whiskers. I'll put a few whiskers on her. A few little whiskies. Need the right brush for whiskers. So the whiskers, I'm going to use a rigger brush. And some of them are black. And some of them are white. So if I just do like 1, 2, 3, I'll load up with some kind of grey as well. 4, there's some down here. And maybe one more there. Maybe a couple there. There's actually some here. With, you know how they have those kind of moly things, and I still feel that face needs a little bit of work. The eye now, just touch that up a bit. A little bit of pink white, a little bit of pinky grey for this bit here, so we can go down here a bit more. Just get that shape a bit better. Yeah. Oh, it's my little tiny brush. And then I'm gonna stop and think about it. Because, well, it's just what you need to do. Stop and think. I could. Where's that? Yeah, okay. My dingo. My emerging dingo. The emerging dingo. Finishing touches. Grey, a little bit of grey. Just gonna soften this top bit there, and a bit of kind of detail in there. I think I'm good. Let's change the trajectory of that eye there. He looks concerned. Concerned on the dingo. What are you concerned about? The state of the world, I suppose. Not enough game. I'm just going to zoom into that eye. Zoom. Ah, yes, there we are. Look at that. Sorry about the noise. Look at that. Right, so I'm just going to put these little dark bits. Because it is all about. It's about the. Eye, you know, the green. It's all about the eye. I have to go up under there. Okay, he's looking that way. And the schnoz. We could just solve that edge a bit better. This edge, where it kind of goes up into the nose, into the around it. There's plenty of solving to do. Just the end here, like, I don't know, you know, you just I'm concentrating now, sort of, because I'm nearly done. Nearly done. And am I happy?
Yeah, I think I am.
I think I'm pretty happy with this one. It's just sort of what I wanted. Yeah, I reckon we're good. Then I'll go back into my commission work. Some sort of tricky stuff. Okay, well, I think that's okay. My emerging dingo. The emerging dingo. Let's see, bring him a little bit closer. Good, all right. Thank you. Nice chatting to you too. Hope you feel better soon.